he calls me and he says, this community is broken. This is a tragedy beyond tragedies. Is there something we could do for Uvalde?
Memorials appeared at the school and the town square in Uvalde, Texas, in the days following the mass shooting in May of 2022. People from near and far traveled to the sites to mourn. Some wrote cards, some lit candles, and others brought music.
These aren't your everything's gonna be okay songs. The lyrics to these songs express the true tragedy.
Mariachis helped provide comfort to a grieving community and showed how music, in general, can help heal. This is Clarified. On May 24th, 2022, 19 children and two teachers were shot and killed by a gunman at Robb Elementary School in Uvalde, Texas, leaving an entire community devastated. Anthony Medrano, a mariachi musician, organized a busload of musicians from San Antonio, Texas, to play songs for the grieving community.
We as a mariachi community, like the rest of the world, were just shocked. Many of us are educators. We teach the children that look like the ones that were killed and that speak like the ones that were killed and whose parents, you know, talk like the ones that were killed.
Anthony said his friend, artist Cruz Ortiz, went to Uvalde after the shooting to process the tragedy. On his way back, Ortiz called him and asked if he could play music for the community. Mariachi music originated in Mexico, and the bands consist of trumpets, violins, a vihuela, a guitarrón, and sometimes a harp. The musicians wear beautiful suits known as los trajes de charro. It's tradition for mariachis to perform for every occasion in life, including funerals, as a way to comfort the grieving family. With the help of a friend, he secured a charter bus fit for 50 people. That bus was filled within hours. At the town square's memorial site, Anthony instantly felt the weight of the devastation. He saw 21 crosses with the names of the victims, each piled high with flowers, cards, and toys.
I have a 5-year-old goddaughter that I spend a lot of time with, and the toys that I saw on these memorials of these murdered children were the same toys that she has in her toy box. So I personally broke down.
The group played a couple of songs to those who gathered around. They played a song called Amor Eterno, which talks about love and loss.
You could feel everybody spiritually singing it too and being impacted by every word because they heard it before. This is the soundtrack of sorrow.
The group also played a traditional song of farewell called Las Golondrinas. 7-year-old mariachi performer Mateo Lopez also sang a song called México, Lindo y Querido.
Which was very appropriate since this was a very Hispanic community. It was a time to play the music that our culture and our community can relate to.
While singing, mariachis also yell out gritos.
Ay, 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 ay! You know, you do that kind of thing. And you do it in celebration, but a grito is just a scream, a guttural, emotional, inside, coming outside form of emotion, of scream. They don't put a band-aid on the wound. They kind of rip the scab off again so you can get that emotion, so you can expose it. That's the way we process. We have to cry out loud, and these songs do that. The community responded beautifully. I mean, in the sense that they thanked us, they appreciated us, they understood why we were there, and it was very much a healing session right there in front of the memorials.
Just as the musicians provided healing, music has been used as a form of therapy for a very long time. Robert Krout, Professor Emeritus of Music Therapy at Southern Methodist University, has been involved in music therapy work for decades.
What was beautiful about the mariachi band coming to Uvalde is that they were touching base on a cultural level as well as a level responding specifically to the deaths. It doesn't mean that the folks who went and heard them play are suddenly going to be, you know, fine and not have a long and complicated grieving process. But at that time, it's a very visceral, emotional, cultural, and community-building way to express grief.
In a mass casualty event, Robert says it can be overwhelming for people to talk about what happened, and that is where music can help express emotions when words cannot. In music therapy, there's a process called entrainment.
Entrainment is a neurological process where our brain rhythms and other rhythms in our body, including pulse and heartbeat, etc., will match an external stimulus, or will to lock on and synchronize with that. So when people hear rhythms together, it kind of brings them onto the same page.
Playing songs familiar to the loved one can help start the process of reflection.
Other times we might write songs with our clients, and in grief write, you know, songs with family members or loved ones to commemorate that person.
After the trip to Uvalde, Anthony and his friends wanted to commemorate the victims.
We didn't want anybody to forget about what happened.
And they made a corrido.
A corrido is a written report and song lyric of what happened. So it's a news flash.
They named it El Corrido de Los Ángeles de Uvalde.
And it says everything. There's nothing about it that is sugar-coated. It talks about the 90 minutes that they were waiting for help, that they were calling 911. Nobody rushed in to save them, to save some at least. Talked about the assault weapon. Talked about the hurt. Talked about the families fighting to try to get inside to save their own children, but they were held back. And that's why we did it, because we don't want anybody to forget this part of the history, because we want it to end. We don't want this to be repeated. And if we can remember it and recall it and report it, even through music, then maybe we can make a change.